Welcome back, aliens. My name is Davin Reddy, and let's continue with the series on JavaScript. Now, in this video, we'll talk about type conversion and type coercion. Now, why do we have two different words? Let's understand that. Now, first of all, it doesn't matter which language you work with, you have something in common, right? You actually work with data. But sometimes you want to convert your data in specific format. Example, we have talked about data types, right? We have numbers, string, boolean, and there might be an option or there might be a requirement where you have to convert your data from number to string or from string to number or from number to boolean. How do we do that? Now, let me create a variable here. So I will say num. This time I'm using a dark theme, basically a high contrast. So let me know your feedback in the comment section. So finally, we are on the dark theme. Yeah, let me create a number here, right? So this is a number. Now, we have seen how do you print the type of data. Of course, when you want to print the data as it is, we can simply print num, right? Now, this will print data. Example, if I run this code, you got 6. But what if you want to print a type of it? In that case, you can use a very special operator, which we have seen earlier, which is type of, and you can print the type of num. So basically, we are printing two things here. We are printing num and we are printing type of num. And let's see what happens. And you can see we got 6 and we got number. That means the type of this num is number. It is working, right? But what if I want to store this num in a different format? I want this to be in string format. Can we do this? Now, you will think, hey, why do we do that? So example, let's say if you want to store a pin code or a zip code of area, which is the best format? Should you store the zip code in number or in a string format? See, whenever you don't want to perform any operation, it's better to store that in a string format. Example, telephone number, a zip code, or whatever big number you have. When you want to perform calculation, that's where number makes sense, right? So here, I want to store this 6 in a string format. In that case, you have to convert that, right? You have to perform some operation. So we have a specific thing called a string. So we'll pass string here. When you pass this number 6 inside a string, it will give you a string format. So this number is getting stored in a string format now. Will it work? Let's try. So let me just run this code once again, and you can see we got 6. No change in data. Of course, you have not got SIX. What you got is number 6 and you got a string. Okay, so this is working, right? And you can also do reverse. If you have a number in a string format, let's say 1, 2, 3. So now if you run this code, of course, the data is in string format. 1, 2, 3 is in string format. And if you want to perform operation, you have to convert that into number. In order to do that, we can simply say number and you can give a bracket and this will work, right? So if you run this code, you got number. The same thing you can do with boolean. Okay, so you can convert a number with boolean, but that's a different thing. We'll do that later. The interesting thing is this is type conversion, right? You are able to convert a number in different format. This is explicit conversion because basically you as a developer, you are trying to convert a data from one format to other format. It's working, right? But then JavaScript went ahead. JavaScript says, hey, you have type conversions, that's great. Let me give you something called type coercion. Now what it means. So let's say I have a number here. I'll say num, or maybe I will not go for any specific name because num represents a name, right? So I will go with, let's say x. I know it's not a good variable name, but just for the example here, we can go with it. So let's say I have a variable x and I want to print x here and I want to print the type of it. Of course, we are printing the data, we are printing the type of this data and the output you are getting is undefined. Of course, that makes sense, right? Now what I will do here is I will assign data to it. So when you assign the data, it will change the type of it. Now what data I want to assign, let me just do that here. So I will say x is equal to 6 or maybe a different number this time. So let's go for x equal to 8. Now, if you do the same thing, I just want to copy and paste. Actually, I'm just reusing the code, right? So after changing the value of x, now let's try. So you can see we got undefined because that was the first time. And then we got 8 number because this is the number. If I change the same thing again, let's say I want to perform some operation. So I can simply say x is equal to, I want to add x with a string. What do you think? What will happen? And what type of string I want to add? Maybe I just want to add empty string. I don't even have some specific type of string here, right? It's an empty string. Now what will happen? Of course, I should also print the console here. Okay, now let me try. And you can see this time we got string. So basically, whenever you have a number and you have a string, this plus operator here, it got confused. The idea behind a plus operator is to add two numbers, right? But this time we have a number and a string. Confusion, right? So coercion comes into picture. So JavaScript says, okay, in this case, every time you have two different data and you want to perform some operation, you have to come to some consensus, right? Either both has to be same type. It should be both string or both number. So in this case, it goes for the string because we have string at one end. Now, when you have string and when you use plus operator, it is actually concatenation. So basically, we are joining two strings. So example, let's say you have Naveen, you have Reddy, two different strings. You use a plus operator. Basically, you are concatenating it. In this case as well, even if you have X, which is a number, and you have a string, it will convert that into string. But not always. Not always when you use a string and a number, it will give the same results. Example, let's say at this point, if you see this is a type of string, right? This X is a type of string. What if I do X equal to X minus 2? Now you tell me what will happen. Of course, I have to print it as well. So pause this video and let me know what will happen. Because X is a string now, 2 is a number. So how it should behave? Should we get 8 minus 2, 6? Or should we get some weird answer? Or maybe it should be NaN, right? Which is because you are subtracting a number from a string. And that is weird. So let's see what happens. So if you run this code, I hope you have answered that in the comment section. You got number. So this is what happens. When you have a subtraction operator with a string, it will convert that into number. So this is type conversion. So based on what type of operator you're using, based on what's the requirement, JavaScript engine will change that for you. In fact, we can also do with Boolean. So we know, right, Boolean is true or false. Now, the way you can manipulate Boolean is with the help of some operators. One of them is exclamation. Exclamation will simply replace, or it will do the opposite. So if it is true, it will give you false. If it is false, it will give you true, right? So exclamation actually means not. So there's a not operator with Boolean, which will change the type. So from true to false, false to true. Now, let me just do that. So I will say X equal to not X. So even if it is a number format, so you can see X in this case is number, right? So you are applying a not operator on number, because the not will only work with Boolean, right? And you are giving a number. So in this case, it will convert that into Boolean and then it will perform the not operation. And let's see what happens. But the question is, will you get true or false? So even if I say it converts this from number to Boolean, what happens? Is it true or false? Let's try. Let's run this code. Oh, I'm not printing it. My bad. Let me print this and you can see we got false Boolean. So Boolean makes sense, but why false? That means you are performing an operation. The output of that operation is false. That means initially the value of X was true. That means if you try to convert a number into Boolean, if that number is 6, it will give you true. Only 6? It's actually any number. Example, let me just do that. So what I will do is I will just go to console and console.log and let me convert a number. Let's say I have a number 7 and I want to convert this into Boolean. How do we convert a number into Boolean? The same way we did it for the number and string with the help of that keyword number string. Here, let me use Boolean. So I'm passing 7 to a Boolean, right? So it will convert this 7 into a Boolean format. But what you will get? Will you get true or false? Let's try. So when I run this code, you can see we got true. Okay, so for 6, it is giving you true. For 7, it is giving you true. I thought it will be even odd. So even numbers will get true, odd number will get false, but that's not the case. Every number is giving you true. Let me try a negative number. So if I say minus 7, let's see, still true. Okay, now after trying out all the different combinations, let's try 0. And the moment you try 0, and if you run this code, you can see we got false. That means all the numbers are true, only 0 is false. Why? It's because the actual implementation of Boolean happens in that way. 0 is false, 1 is true, right? If it is not 0, everything is true. You can actually calculate with each number. So they simply go with simple formula. If it is 0, it's false. If it is all the other numbers, it is true. And this is called a truthy and a falsy values. I know that's tricky. It's not just with numbers, it's also with other types. Example, let me convert into Boolean of type null. Now what will happen? If you try to convert null into Boolean, and if you run this code, you can see we got false. So even null is a falsy value. So whenever you try to convert something into Boolean, and if that gives you false, it is falsy value. If you pass something and if you're trying to convert that into Boolean, if it is giving you true, that's called a truthy value. Example, after some time, we'll start working with functions, objects, whatever your data you pass. So if you try to convert object into Boolean, it will give you true. If you try to pass a function into and convert it into Boolean, it will give you true. Cool. What about undefined? Let me just try that. So when you try it with undefined also, it will give you false. So these are all falsy values. Okay, apart from this, everything is truthy value. So you can see the list. If you have something like this, and if you try to convert these things into Boolean, you will get false. And all the other thing will give you true. Let me just try with a string. We have not tried with string yet. So what I will do is, I'll pass a string like Naveen. Now what happens? Naveen is true or false? Of course, Naveen is true. Let's try. And you can see we got true. Now since it's not a part of the falsy values, it's true. So just to reiterate, whenever you have a number and a string, it will convert that into string when you apply the addition operator. But when you perform the subtraction operator, it will convert into number. So JavaScript is smart enough to know what should be done. And that's one thing I love and hate about JavaScript. We love this thing because it helps you. It actually understands what you need and it will give the output. The reason I also hate it is because it tries to convert things the way it wants. Sometimes you don't intend to do that and you want errors, but JavaScript says, okay, you're doing this, I will allow you and I will help you here. We don't want your help, we want errors, because this will eventually lead to bugs. Okay, and that's why you have to be very alert when you're doing these operations. In fact, we have some more ways. Example, let's say I want to do plus operator here, right? So we have x in string format here and you want to, okay, let me just remove this part just to make it simple. Yeah, so we have x, which is string format, right? So if you run this code, so you can see we got 82 because you have 8 here, which is x, and then you got 2, so you got 82. But in this case, I want to convert this into a number. In that case, you can use unary operators. Of course, we'll talk about operators later in detail, but so whenever you add a plus here, it tries to convert this string into number. Let's try that. And you can see we got number. So we got 10, which is the addition of 8 and 2, and you got a number. Okay, there are more ways actually to convert this string into integer or the other format. So let me just try that. So let's say we have x and the value of x is 1, 2, 3, Naveen. Okay, now in this case, I want to convert this into a number format. But of course, you can't convert that into number format, right? Because we have Naveen there. So if you try to do that with the help of a number function, so let's say if I do, let me just print that first as it is. Let's see what happens if you print this. And you can see we got 1, 2, 3, Naveen. Okay, that works. But if you try to convert that into number, because we did that before, let's see what happens. So if you try to do that, and if you run this code, you can see we got nan, which is not number. We don't want this. What we want is it should be able to convert that and at least fetch these first integer values. So in this case, you can actually use parseInt. So parseInt is a special function which will accept a string. It will try to convert it into number. Okay, it will do its hard work to convert a string into number. And you can see we got 123. But what happens if you have a character at the start? In this case, it will not work. So you have to make sure that you have numbers at the start, so it will try to convert that into numbers, right? So that's how you can do it. So try out different functions. You can go to Google and search for different type conversions functions and you will get those. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section and do subscribe for other videos. Bye-bye.